you can put toothpaste on spots as a treatment.
No.
I always wonder where that one came from.
I think my mum told me that when I was younger as well, but no.
Keep your toothpaste for your teeth.
Yeah. Acne isn't just a surface level concern. It's a medical condition that requires attention and care. Acne affects people of all ages and can severely impact a person's self-esteem and quality of life. Today, we're shedding light on the facts surrounding acne and how pharmacists and GPs can provide valuable assistance in managing this condition. I'm Jo Hoare, and you're watching The Skin Clinic with Boots.
So I've got two brilliant Boots experts with me on the sofa to talk all about acne. Whitney, do you want to go first? What do you do for Boots?
Yes, so I work as a Boots store-based pharmacist, so I provide a range of services, for example, blood pressure checks. We also offer the pharmacy first service and also just services regarding patient health, so regular health MOT checks, checking patients' weight, height, waist circumference as well. I also offer travel vaccination services and also the general checking prescriptions too.
Meena, what about you?
So I'm a GP and I work for Boots Online Doctor. In particular, I work as the clinical lead for the dermatology and mental health services as well.
Which are available by the Boots website.
Correct, yes.
What is acne? How, Meena, would you define acne in a patient?
So acne is a chronic inflammatory condition and it can affect all ages. We have severity types from mild, moderate to severe, but what's really important is what the patient perceives their skin condition to be as well. Acne has many forms, but the one that we're probably more familiar with is acne vulgaris, and that is where we have dead skin cells associated, or skin proteins rather, associated with oil, sebum, that can lead to, or we may be familiar with the terms blackheads and whiteheads as well. This can then develop into more painful spots as well, and cystic types of acne, which can be a more severe type.
And is there a point from a clinical point of view where spots become acne, or is it, as you say, the perception, the impact on someone's life?
I would say it's more the perception on someone's life.
When you say cystic acne, what's that going to look like and how's that going to feel for the patient?
Cystic acne would be a really large cyst or a spot, really painful, really sore, quite distressing as well. We would advise, you know, to see your GP or come to Boots Online Doctor. And there are prescribed treatments that are there on offer, but then also more treatments that may require hospital intervention. But the majority of acne can be treated with your local, you know, pharmacist or your GP as well.
So ports of call are pharmacy, GP, online doctor, but there's lots of help out there for
exactly
access.
Absolutely.
What's the difference between acne and rosacea?
Rosacea tends to be redness, particularly on the cheeks or in the face. It can be associated with flushing as well. Rosacea can develop with thickening of the skin, but also you do get spots with it. So we term it papular pustula.
So we're going to have a bit of a quick fire quiz here about some myths about acne. I think there's loads of myths, old wives' tales, misconceptions, call them what you will. I think there's still loads of confusion out there around acne. So I'm going to ask you both to either confirm or deny some of these myths. Touching our face a lot can make our acne or our spots worse.
It definitely can. As you can imagine, on a day-to-day basis, we are touching so many different things, from our phones to different surfaces, and all of these contain and can hold bacteria. So when we are putting it on our faces, the bacteria is going straight to our face, and this can actually make our acne much more worse.
And you said phones there as well. So what about the surface of our phone? If we're holding that up to our face, do we need to be careful with that as well?
Yes, we have to regularly clean our phone surfaces, either with a disinfectant spray or with disinfectant wipes, just so that the bacteria on our phones doesn't get to our faces.
What about popping or squeezing spots? I can already see that. Absolutely not,
because that can lead to scarring, and obviously that obviously has potential, you know, consequences as well. So avoid picking, avoid touching, we've already said, avoid squeezing. It's better to have, you know, treat acne as early as possible.
And what about your makeup brushes?
regularly wash them.
it's a really bad beauty habit, isn't yeah. it? Anyway, to be leaving our brushes to get dirty.
Our makeup brushes contain a lot of makeup. As you can imagine, every single time that we do apply makeup, we are reapplying the previous makeup that we've done to our bases, and that can also hold bacteria too.
This is a massive myth. You only get acne when you're a teenager and you'll grow out of it.
Well, that's what we all thought, but we know we do see a lot of adult onset acne. So acne can come in your teenage years, it can come during your adult years, it can come much later on in life. We also know women, when they're going through their menopause, can also develop acne as well. Acne, you know, there's hormonal influences, environmental influence as well.
We can get acne at any age. And if you're a teenager who has acne, I can't imagine how unhelpful it is just to hear that you'll grow out of it, because that's not actually even true.
No, I mean, you know, you can grow out of it, but and then maybe later on develop adult onset, but that's why treating it is just so important, especially in the early, you know, onset of it as well.
It's bad hygiene, or you're dirty, or you're not washing enough.
Not at all. I mean, as I've already said, you know, there's other influences such as hormonal and environmental influences as well. So I don't think, you know, it is because you're dirty at all, and that's important to remember that. However, a good skincare hygiene is important as well, and that's important in helping, you know, maintain your skin.
I suppose actually you could almost go the other way. So if you are someone with acne and blemishes, you could be overwashing your face if you're feeling very anxious about it and putting very harsh products on.
Exactly. So I always think keep it simple, don't use too many products. And using more aggressive, harsh treatments that can really be aggravating your skin and your acne as well. So
treat it kindly.
Absolutely.
Acne, is it infectious? Am I gonna catch it from someone?
Not at all, no, absolutely not. So it's not an infectious condition, but you know, we do have bacteria on our skin which can lead to the acne spots we've talked about earlier.
If you've got acne, and you want to cover it, you can still do that?
You can still wear makeup products, preferably makeup products which are specifically oil-free or non-comedogenic products as well. That's quite useful.
So there's no need to ditch your foundation, ditch your face, because we know that's going to give people more confidence if it is something, but you just need to be careful about what you're choosing.
Exactly, yes.
You can put toothpaste on spots as a treatment.
No. I always wonder where that came from.
I think my mum told me that when I was younger as well, but no.
It's quite a retro one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like, keep your toothpaste for your teeth.
Yeah.
What would you say if you had a patient that came to you and said that they felt that the sun was kind of their solution?
Sun protection is really important, and using sunbeds to treat acne is not the way to do it, absolutely not.
If someone comes in and they want something that they can buy over the counter, what would you recommend?
So there are different products that are available over the counter, for example, products that contain benzoyl peroxide. These products specifically help to dry out the specific spots or the specific areas that have acne, just so that the oil control in that area is minimized.
What is a basic skincare regime that you would recommend to a patient suffering from acne?
Really simple, cleansing your skin at least twice a day, just to remove the everyday dirt that could be on your face. Using a moisturiser as well, so something that's oil-free, and also sun protection as well. That's really important to maintain, and it doesn't matter what time of year it is.
But if someone is watching this and they have got some real concerns around their skin and how acne is affecting them, what's the piece of advice that you'd like to give them today?
I would say don't suffer alone. It's really important to seek help and treatment. We talked about, you know, what your pharmacist can do, what your GP can do to help, and to seek treatment early as well. That's really important. So absolutely seek help and do that early on as well.
I think lots of people maybe have a bit of a worry that the GP is not going to take them seriously, or they're going to think it's just something cosmetic, but that's not the case, is it?
No, not at all. You know, we talked about how acne is a chronic inflammatory condition. Absolutely, it is a serious condition as well. So, and we should or will be taken seriously by your health professional.
Thank you.
If you need further advice, pop into your local Boots Pharmacy and your pharmacist will be happy to help.
Alternatively, you can visit your GP or head to Boots Online Doctor for more advice and services.